We're really excited to have you join us today, so please join us in singing Light the Fire.
Oh, join me in the unison prayer. Lord, make us an instrument of your peace in this, our church community and faith family. Help us be aware of the needs of our brothers and sisters. Where there is anger, let us show love. Where there is injury, let us offer pardon. Where there is despair, let us bring hope. Where there is darkness, let us see as light. Where there is sadness, let us be consoling. Where there is loneliness, let us bring people together. Help us comfort one another. Help us understand one another. Help us to love one another. Show us how to be your people. We who are brothers and sisters in this faith family. Amen. And now, as the congregation sings hymn number 2088, Lord, I lift your name on high, the children are invited to come forward for a moment with Chaplain.
You are worthy.
You are worthy.
Worthy of lesson, which is Matthew 25, 31 through 40. When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, he will sit on his glorious throne. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate the people one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will put the sheep on his right, and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, "Come, you who are blessed by my Father, take your inheritance, the kingdom prepared for you since the creation of the world. For I was hungry, you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you invited me in. I needed clothes, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you looked after me. I was in prison, and you came to visit me." Then the righteous will answer, "Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you something to drink? When did we see you a stranger and invite you in, or needing clothes and clothe you? When did we see you sick or in prison and go to visit you?" The king will reply, "Truly I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me."
Hand we take periodic nut or butter with spray cheese breaks. Overall, we not only learned a lot about one another, but we also helped each other find a little more about ourselves. Probably one of the most notable God moments was when we had been working out on the porch for a while, when the son Michael came out of the house. As we passed by Andrew asked him how he was doing, and he responded that he was good. Then Michael whispered something to Andrew, feeling a connection with him. And Andrew said, "That's great," and continued to congratulate him. It turned out that Michael, the newly graduated high school senior, had been accepted to a nearby college so that he could study to become a police officer. After telling us this, he excused himself and decided that he should probably go in and let his mother know too. In my life, I have battled many internal struggles, but then I witnessed all the struggle and strain that these ASP families have faced, yet they still have the courage to stand on 2 feet and praise God for something as simple as a beautiful day. This trip really puts in perspective what it means to live a life dedicated to faith and service. I truly believe that it's not just that hard labor builds the character, but the families you work for and people you meet rebuild your hope for society, for your life, and give you the strength to trust in your faith another day. For me, I felt called to do more. I know every year I want to go back and do it all again, but this year I felt especially that way. I felt like I was supposed to go back next year. For more than a week, I become a staffer. A staffer? Are you sure? That was my first reaction. But as the week went on, I felt more and more that way. Seeing what it would actually be like, I felt like it was the right place for me. It seemed scary to be going off to college and only coming home a few times and for breaks. But now I was feeling called to give up my summer and be away from home even longer. As scary as it is, I feel the need to do it. To step away from my comfort zone completely and follow God's plan for my life and not question it. I know I'll become stronger as I go through my first year of college, but I'm sure it will seem scary. I'm sure it will still seem scary if in May I'm preparing to leave 2 weeks after school without for the entire summer. Who knows where God will take me in the coming months, but this ASP really taught me to follow that instinct. Follow God's call, no matter what it is. Maybe it will be being on staff, or maybe He will find another great way to use me. Either way, ASP this year and over the past 5 years has taught me a whole lot more than just how to hammer in a apostello. Go out into the world and live your life on purpose.
We worked at a home belonging to a family of four. It really opened my eyes and made me grateful for all that God has blessed me with. The family's grandmother had the greatest influence on me. What amazed me was how she was willing to do anything for her family. Every day when we walked into the work site, she would be working on a quilt. At the end of one day's work, I commented on it. She told me she was making quilts to provide for her family. I was impressed by how strong her work ethic was despite her aging body. She showed me true selflessness and what it means to put others before yourself. Overall, this experience showed me what it was like to be a part of the body of Christ. 1 Corinthians 12 refers to us as the body of Christ. This experience has given me the opportunity to become God's hand for me. During the week, we picked up floors, or in my case, sledgehammered them in. We painted, put in floor, and provided them with KFC on Friday. These seem like simple things, but they meant everything to the family that we served.
I know, great transformation. Maddie is often a young life trip. trip, and so I have her reflection to read. Maddie wants to tell us that she's so thankful for the opportunity to go on ASP this summer. She says, I had a blast and made such special connections with so many great people, especially my work group. I saw God on ASP through all people being so grateful, not only for our help, but for what they already had. Even though to us it may not have seemed like much, they were all very proud of what they already had and more than willing to share it with everyone. I found it so touching that they were willing to give whatever they could to others without a second thought or anything in return.
Everybody wants a mute button to hit before your hand is to the pastor. Who doesn't want that? That was amazing. And it almost worked, but thanks for saving. Thank you to all of you for your reflections and your witnesses. This is a time when we come together as a church family in prayer, and I want to invite us first into a time of silence where you can lift up whatever prayers are in your heart today. We ask you to please be particularly aware of the family of Vernley Temple, who passed away this week, and her service is tomorrow morning at 10 at Owens Funeral Home. And then we also want to remember Vernon Todd, who has been in the hospital. As we pray together, you're invited any time to let a spoken prayer come forth, and let it be whatever it is, and then I'll lead us forward in prayer. Let's be together in a spirit of prayer. Tender and loving God, we're so grateful for your amazing love for us that changes our hearts and our lives, that takes our brokenness and heals us, our fragile selves, these clay jars in which there is such a treasure that we have placed, the treasure of love, goodness and kindness and relationship. And we're grateful for the opportunity to serve in Appalachia, to build relationships even as we build houses, to come to know people as people, to come to know one another better and love one another more fully as we serve you and as we serve each other. We're grateful for the tradition that we have in this congregation of sharing the Appalachia Service Project for over 20 years, and for the difference that it makes in our lives, the difference that it has made in the lives of people in Appalachia. God, we're grateful for opportunities that we have to serve here in Champaign, Urbana as well. We know that some of us are called to go away, and others might be hearing the call to go away. Some of us are called right here to the places that are nearby to make a difference, to build relationships, and to extend your tender love into this community. And so help us, God, in our workplaces, in our play places, in our school places, in our home places, in our neighborhoods. Help us to build others up and to find ways to serve. Give us courage to serve as you call us to do. God, we are aware today of a world where there is war and violence, where there is disease that is frightening proportion in some places in this world, where there is loneliness and sickness and disaster and injustice. God, sometimes it overwhelms us, but we know that you can use us, and we pray that you would use us, and we pray for all who are doing good, who are seeking to serve and to love and to extend your healing and care into the world. Lift them up, even as you lift us up, to be your servants everywhere. Help us to love your people here in downtown Champaign, to be open hearts and open minds and open doors that welcome others into the very center of your love. We pray these things, God, in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we are indeed one body together. Amen. And Zach Forsyth, he offered to stand right next to me during this prayer, but, I mean, come here, Zach. What do you think that feels like? Zach's going to lead us in the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you, Zach, for leaving the microphone on. That was probably the first silent ministry moment we've ever had. It's meant to be silent, and it is an invitation to be a part of the Angelville or Habitat for Humanity. Like we say, some folks are called to go away, and some folks are called right here. And we invite you to be a part of Habitat for Humanity, and you can contact Ron Lyman for more information about that. But also, at that time to make soup for Time Center, and there's information in the bulletin about just exactly the steps that we need to take in order to do that. So please be encouraged in these ways to know that together we're making a difference in the world and in downtown Champaign, and we thank you for doing that. There's a yellow insert always in your bulletin. That's your opportunity to sign in, as we say, to say that you're here. And we invite you to please fill that out as completely as you are willing to do so and place it in the offering plate this morning. And thank you for doing that. Whoever you are, you're welcome here today. If you're here for the first time or you're relatively new among us, please do feel right at home and make yourself at home. Our hearts and our minds and our doors are open to you, and there's a place for you. As a forgiven and reconciled people, let's offer ourselves and our gifts to God.
Thank you.
We are connected today, and we are forever connected to the people we serve on ASP. So remember to go out and serve others, and you can build relationships with others while you are building something for them. Oh, and please stay, sorry guys, please stay if you would like for our ASP.